As the partial government shutdown in the United States has entered its third week, it has become the longest shutdown in U.S. history. Over 800,000 federal workers are receiving no pay, with many protesting at federal buildings. Because of this, many employees of the TSA, the security screeners at U.S. airports, have been calling in sick. Others have just quit. The Miami International Airport took the drastic step of closing a concourse entirely. An airport spokesman expressed concern about operations there.
The shutdown's real, so it is having some impact. We are seeing higher than number TSA screeners call out from work and not show up to work. Those that are here are doing a great job, and they're screening passengers, and wait times remain the same. But we do want to be prepared.
In addition to travelers on the ground facing issues, there could also be problems in the skies. The Federal Aviation Administration, the FAA, also said that they are delaying safety inspections of aircraft. And while air traffic controllers are required to work even without pay, many are not showing up for shifts.
The safety programs that we've been working on to build the ultimate safety culture that we've had in the last 10 years completely come to a stop. As this continues to go on, the layers of safety are being reduced into our airspace system for no reason whatsoever.
While the safety of aircraft could be impacted by fewer inspections, issues in flight could also arise. A representative for flight attendants expressed her concerns.
Our profession changed forever on September 11th, 2001, and we became aviation's last line of defense. But aviation security is layered. We are less safe and we are less secure. Safety and security is non-negotiable.
The shutdown is causing anxiety among workers, many who may live paycheck to paycheck, about how to pay their bills without any income.
If this continues on, then it will be an issue. I do have other bills that are due on the 15th, and I've successfully been able to negotiate with my creditors to be able to delay and push out the loan payment another month. So, those kinds of juggling of finances, I'm sure everybody has their own set of issues.
Until the shutdown issue is resolved in Washington, D.C., ordinary people will have to find solutions for their financial troubles one way or another.